hi there. It's Janet, and Ed and I are in George's kitchen today with Bill, because today we're going to be demonstrating how to process some broccoli for freezing. And I just wanted to point out a couple of good books that you can get. One is the Ball's Blue Book. This one actually has canning and freezing in it. I looked it up, and because it's old, they don't actually do that anymore and have that in there. Bernarden as well has a great canning book, which should be consulted when you're doing any canning for the proper times. But you can look these things up online. The best one I found was called canadianfamily.net/food-preservation, and you will find things like this that they all say the same times for how long you should be blanching. So today we're doing broccoli. It recommends for a medium size to blanch it for 3 minutes, and that's what we're going to do. So, my dear George, please take it away.
All right. So, well,
what
first,
prompted this? What happened?
What's that?
Well,
the bottom line is that I'm going to start by getting some hot water going here, and because we need water to get a roll and boil.
Now that's cool.
So what prompted this is that you grow all these vegetables in your garden, and you give a lot away. You try to keep, you know, what you can eat, but you can't keep everything you have unless you process it so that it lasts you through the winter. So I've learned to do that, I don't know, maybe 7-8 years ago. I blanch cauliflower, broccoli, beans. I snap peas this year. Things that I, you know, that in season are fantastic, but they won't last, you know, forever.
Yeah.
And this way, I have enough vegetable for the whole winter, and it's always, you know, if you look at what you buy in vegetables, frozen vegetables, it's exactly the same method, except, you know, you control absolutely everything.
This way preserves the enzymes and the vitamins, and it kills the bacteria, so that you're freezing. Your product is going to stay frozen and keep its goodness longer.
Yeah, no chance for salmonella poisoning.
Right. And it turns them a nice green, and it preserves the color, and that's what they do. And really, when you buy frozen vegetables, they're a lot of times in better shape than the ones you buy in the grocery store that may have been picked quite a while ago. So
they're in much better shape.
Yeah,
they haven't been handled, right? They went straight from the field to the packing plant, you know. And the other ones, they were handled. They were brought into an area where they're kept, you know, until they're ready for, or there's a demand for them on the market. So they're handled from the field to the warehouse back to the grocer. The grocer puts them, you know, where once they're frozen, doesn't matter. They're behind plastic. They're in a bag. There's no chance of anything bad happening. You know? So basically, you want the water to be as cold as possible. That's why I'm going to add some ice to this. And what that ice bath does is that it sets the color on the vegetables. It's going to help it have that beautiful bright green. Makes it super appetizing when you go to use it, one. But the other thing that it does is that it stops the cooking process to the core of the vegetable so that it doesn't continue to cook and therefore doesn't get mushy, you know. So I'm going to go get some ice and get a nice bath going. But I think between now and then we should cut some vegetables.
Okay.
You feel like helping?
Sure.
All right. We're going to do some little flowerets. So I'm going to give you a knife here. Oh, hang on. I'm going to have to sharpen that. It's okay. It takes 2 seconds. And what's that? That's it. In the Big Arlene. Okay, careful not to cut yourself. That's going to be very, very sharp. And so remove the bottom here. That's no good. And from there, you just separate the flowerettes like that. I don't know if you can see, Ed. Just work your way around. There's something else that I want to say. If it's your own broccoli, okay, sometimes you'll have the whole stem. Never throw that out. Never throw that out because if you peel that part of the broccoli, it's absolutely delicious. You can use it in soups, whatever. So there's no waste, bottom line is.
So yeah, you have a big stalk and you just peel back the...
Yeah. Just like,
yep. It's really good.
You use a vegetable peeler, just like that, okay? And if that was the big stem, then you just peel it, just like so. All right? And that makes it super tender, delicious.
Yeah, I think those are...
They're absolutely gorgeous. So, Janet, here's how this is going to go, okay? We're going to dump this into the boiling water, but first, we're going to make this water, the water bath as cold as possible with the ice.
Perfect.
Okay. And you're going to operate the timer.
All right.
So, as I say, I'm going to dump all of this in. And we got a nice rolling boil. And if you look, perfect, it's on. Now, if you look, you'll notice that it set the color right away, turned much deeper green. So that's going to go in for the required amount of time. So we try to return to the boil as quick as possible.
Yeah. And they say to keep the lid on to keep the heat in there.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But
okay,
that's a huge pot, right?
Yeah.
And so there's at least a gallon and a half of water in there.
We're done.
Okay, we're done. So, and we are back in the boil, as you can tell. And so now we remove it. We're just going to cancel this by hitting timer.
Oh, okay.
I was referring, you know, I was counting on my lovely assistant, but she fell down on the job.
Oh, look, there's one that got missed. Okay, they're all coming out.
They're all coming out.
And they look perfect. They're really a beautiful green.
A spider would work better, but oh, you know what a spider is, right? Those big metal.
Yeah, like
things.
A big baskety thing that goes in there.
Okay, and now
we got
them all, but we make sure we submerge them in the ice, the ice bath.
Stir them around a little bit.
Yep. And there's no rush, right? The bottom line is they're going to go from there. And what we're going to do is we're just going to put them on the counter here. And so I use these things because no sense using paper towel. You know, you're using paper towel for nothing. Okay. Okay. Now... Okay, put this here. You're fired. You're fired.
I've got a bad wing too. I can't use my right arm right now.
Okay. So we'll leave it a few more seconds. And we're gonna put some parchment paper on there. Prevent things from sticking. Yeah, it's good stuff.
Okay, so
we're gonna drain them nice and dry, or you know, as dry as we can.
That's the last one.
That's the last one. Okay. Inspector Janet, would you like to confirm?
Yes, perfect.
All right.
Cap these dry.
Yeah. So, we're going to use a paper towel for the top.
Could you just use this one here?
Yeah, you can.
Okay.
We're going to be gentle with them.
It's a nice linen one.
Yeah, I know.
Right.
So now, this is going to go here. And same thing, Janet, the idea is to keep them separated so they can basically freeze as single units, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And once they're frozen, you can handle however you want, handle them however you want there. great. So from there, I'm going to put this in the freezer, lay it flat, and wait until it freezes. Once it's frozen, what I like to do is I use a really large bag, a Ziploc bag, but an extra large one, something like this one here, right? And everything's frozen in portion sizes. So I can open one up to show you. So if I'm cooking something and I need some peas, I grab a bag and I got a portion for two. Four people, two bags. Awesome. Simple math, you know.
Yeah.
French Canadian, I got to keep it as simple as possible.
Oh, George, thank you so much for demonstrating how to preserve your broccoli. And this can be applied to any of the vegetables that you
Can do carrots,
all kinds of things.
Beets.
Yeah. You can have online for the proper times and stuff and call it the same way.
And the thing is that we spent all this time, you know, like growing these vegetables, and we ended up, like, for most years before I started doing that, I'd give it all away.
Yeah.
And I grew enough to satisfy my needs for the whole year, but then I'd have to go out and buy some again, right? So this way, you've got fresh, frozen, delicious, nutritious vegetables, and it doesn't prevent you from giving some away to your friends either, right?
No, and you don't need a lot of equipment. I mean, you might have to buy some ice and some Ziploc bags, but really that's about it.
Yeah, so absolutely.
You can do it, right, Bill? Are you going to give it a go, Bill, next time?
There you go.
Well, Bill and I, we made some at his place while you were growing so much nice cauliflower, and Bill was giving it all away, and I said, no, Bill, let me come over, and I'll show you how it's done, and so we put some in his freezer for him for the winter.
Oh, that's great.
And I'm happy to help anybody who wants help, you know, just get a hold of me, and I'll come and give you a hand.
Well, thanks so much, George, for inviting us into your kitchen.
You're always welcome in my home, Janet.
Well, you're invited to my place.
It's almost so much fun.
Okay.
So much fun to banter with you.
So
all right. Take care, everybody.
Bye.